Red wattled lapwing, the day dawns for the birds with the sunrise. Chirpings mark the beginning of the routine of these birds. One such bird, commonly found with other birds around the human settlements, is red wattled lapwing. A red wattle on the nose and a particular mix of red, black, and white colors. That is red wattled lapwing for you. It's a bird that spends its life on the land and plays an important role in maintaining nature's balance. The lapwings pick up their movements in the Marathi month of Shishir. It's an indication of the ensuing mating period. The pairs start their search for right places around bushes, drainages, and ponds for building their nests. Once this is done, begins the mating. A green signal from the female and the male runs after her, making a call of tirr. The female bends her legs and slants her rear towards the earth. The male jumps over her, flutters his wings, and they mate. A mating lasts for 7 to 10 seconds. This process is repeated several times during the day. With mating begins construction of a nest on the earth. Both dig soil with their legs, rub their bellies over it, and create a palm-deep pit which is filled with hard clay balls picked with the help of beaks. Mating and nest building go on during the same period. A pair builds 4 to 5 such nests in close proximity of each other and protects them. However, the pair uses just one of them for laying eggs. It's after 30 to 40 days of mating that the female starts laying eggs. Taking into account the climate, availability of food and security, and the female lays 2 to 4 eggs, which are of ash white color with small black spots on them. The color combination is meant for camouflage, for these eggs are under constant threat as they are laid in a nest on the land. It's perhaps the nature's way of protecting them from enemies. Unminding food and water, the pair alternatively sits on the eggs. During this period, they stay extremely alert to protect their eggs from enemies on land and in the air. The eggs are under constant threat from cats, dogs, snakes, and sparrowhawks. The pair gives everything to protect them. Even in the extreme heat of May, the female sits on eggs. But when the temperature in the nest rises, she goes to the nearby drain, rubs her belly against water, and returns to her nest. This ensures balance of temperature in the nest. Chicks to come out of the shells. Moments after their birth, the chicks start following their mother, picking grass seeds, insects, etc. The mother shelters them under her wings when there is a threat from hunters. The chicks start feasting on the food they find in the drainages. It's unique of the lapwings that they don't feed their chicks. During this period, mother is their constant companion while the male sits at a distance keeping a vigil over the possible threat. Both stay extremely alert in this work. A call of security from the male and both resume their search for food. Chicks try to stay around their parents. A month after their birth, the chicks appear to start their routine, adopting most of the rules of security. They start clearing their wings with the beak, try to flutter them. They also take little flights during this period. It's peculiar of the young of the lapwing that it keeps searching for its food even in the night under the security cover of parents. That is why one can listen to their different calls in the night hours also. The other birds living on the land also manage to protect themselves from enemies and threats. This enables those birds to grow and protect their clan in the better way. This indeed a big ideal for the modern and intelligent animal called a human. Days pass by, and by the end of 45 to 60 days period, the chicks grow in size, their movements increase. They attempt to spread both their wings. This relieves the parents to some extent. Nevertheless, they stay focused on their security. With the wings getting almost fully developed and gaining a strength in a month and a half's time, the young ones start flying on their own. These flights are about 50 meters high. This reduces responsibility of security on the parents to some extent, for the young ones can now fly to a safer place at the sight of any serpentine threat. They also learn to fly to nearby areas to find their food on their own. Some 2-3 months pass by. It's now time for other chicks to break out of the eggs laid after the second session of mating. It's also a time for the grown-ups to take a high flight into the sky to bid a final goodbye to the parents and to start a life of their own. By this time, black clouds cloud the skyline and the monsoon sets in to the drenched soil to rejuvenate the life on the earth.